Today, we are seeking out the Hall of Horrors here at Joshua Tree National Park. And I ain't kidding either. I'm being for real. If you look at the park map, there's actually a stop called the Hall of Horrors. And you see a lot of people stop here at the parking lot where the bathrooms are. They come out, they take a few pictures, but many of them don't realize that there is a true Hall of Horrors somewhere beyond these rocks. And that is what I intend to find today. All right, so I live in Arizona and October's coming up, the haunt season, all that. I love that stuff. And I don't live in a place where I can actually go visit that. But I thought of something. I'm gonna one up all those other YouTubers that frequent those things by finding a real Hall of Horrors. This is not for the weak of heart. So I was looking at the park map earlier and Hall of Horrors just jumped out at me. I seek out dark stuff, I think, for some reason. But anyway, I did some quick internet research and I found a blog that talks about behind this group of rocks here is another group of rocks. And inside of that is a slot canyon-like crack in the rocks that you can go inside. I think that is the Hall of Horrors, I assume. And I'll give you a little more information as we walk that way. But I'm just reading someone's blog post and it didn't have a lot of information in it. I saved the webpage on my phone before I came here and re-reviewed it. So I think I understand how to find it. So this is gonna be an adventure for you and I, Goonies style. So here are the instructions as I understood them. So if you're standing at the bathroom facing this direction, first locate this big group of rocks straight ahead. Hall of Horrors or not, this is a delightful walk through this terrain here. These Joshua trees are enormous. I don't think I've ever seen some this big. I've seen lots of Joshua trees, but even though they're technically not a tree, I'm not as tree the size of a tree. That's for sure. But the Joshua tree, where did it get its name? Well, it's a piece of trivia you're gonna find all around town and online if you look. Basically, the early Mormon settlers of this area, probably in the late 1800s, thought these resembled the biblical figure Joshua with his arms outstretched. And I can kind of see it, it kind of makes sense, but anyway, Joshua tree, there you go. Okay, so there's the second group of rocks. And we need to get in between these things here. And I want to find the clearest path possible. So rattlesnakes might be my biggest hazard of the day, although it's probably very unlikely I'm going to run into that. But the way it sounds like I'm going to be scrambling up some rocks and stuff. I was reading some literature. Rattlesnakes like to hide up in little cracks and things and hunt lizards and other creatures. So I really, when you're doing this, need to really watch where you step, where you put your hands and that kind of stuff. But, you know, I always say this and I never see anything. Maybe today will be the day. Here's another view of that second clump of rocks. Now, he said about 2/3 of the way down here, there was like a Google pin on top of this thing with coordinates. And once I got into the park, I wasn't able to access that information. But apparently we need to scramble and somehow get up in there. And I still have the web page cached in my phone, so I may review it again, but he said if you go down there, there's an easier route up than scrambling up over here, I think. And there's some bushes, I think I see maybe, between the rocks there. That might be where we enter, where the easier route is, so let's go check that out. I actually went to the visitor center before coming into the park today, and I actually read stuff and learned stuff. And I learned how these boulders are formed and why this landscape looks like it does. And I know you're just itching for me to tell you, right? Well, you know I'm gonna tell you, right? I have to. Gotta do my good deed for the day. So, in a long time ago in geologic history, There was magma underneath the earth that was welling up towards the surface, and it didn't quite make it. It cooled underground and formed this form of granite that you see before you. Then all of the pressure on that created cracks in the rocks, and over time, all of the soil on top eroded and those cracks were exposed, weathering, you know, with wind and water to smooth them out and make them look like they do today. That's the short story of how this was formed. Pretty cool. Joshua tree fun fact. Did you know that the pollinators for these plants are not bees, they're moths? I saw that in a visitor center too. That's pretty neat. Okay, so the guy in that blog, or the gal, I forget which it was, said to come about two-thirds of the way down this big rock structure and look for some bushes. I'm wondering if it's that on the other side, and to kind of go back up in there, and that it's easier to ascend. So let's see if that is if that resembles anything. I estimate the Hall of Horrors is right on the other side of this wall, and my best guess is we're gonna have to scramble and climb up that and maybe cut back up that way. All right, so let's see if I can avoid injury or death today once again. I also want to watch out for rattlesnakes, because this looks, I just have a feeling I'm being watched. So right here in front of me are some boulders. I'm gonna try to climb up that and then head off to the left and up and see if that reveals what I'm looking for. The directions I followed said to go around this side and go about two-thirds of the way down there until you see some bushes, and I think it was those bushes. So I came up this way, I climbed up on that boulder there, and there's a really deep gap on either side, so if you fall, you're in trouble. And then I got there and I realized there's another gap that you can't see here. I couldn't jump from there to there, there's no way, so I had to turn around. That wasn't working. So what I did is I walked around this way, and I was thinking about going back to the car, and then I saw a path like down this way that just kind of came up, and it was really easy so far. This was the hardest part, climbing up these rocks, but what I think I need to do now though is get up here. Now this is getting steeper. Right here is a little challenging for me with all this equipment, but I think I can get it done. All right, here's a view from this level. You can see we're ascending now. Part of the reason why they call it the Hall of Horrors is you gotta go through these things with all these spikes that want to impale you. These angry yuccas. They're like, come on, boy, come on through. So far, so good, though. Let's pass through here, the angry yuccas. Ouch, 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 ouch. That wasn't too bad. All right, so what do we have here? Let's take a quick look. All right, I think we found something. What do we got here? Oh my gosh. What are we gonna do? Whoa. I do believe I found the Hall of Horrors. I don't know how I'm gonna get down there though. Well, with my equipment for sure, I don't know. More importantly, how do I get back up? I could probably, that's at an angle, and I could wedge myself down there, but realistically, could I climb back up that in my current shape? The optimist in me says yes, but the realist in me says, hold up there, son. Let's think about this. I would certainly be more considering of that route if it's just me and no equipment. That still would make me nervous. Let's take a peek around this corner here really quick and see if there's an alternate route we can find. All right, let's see. Whoa, I'm hanging over the edge of this thing to get this shot. Look at that. That's giving me vertigo. But I wonder if there's a way to go around that way. And then that's where we want to go, is in that darkness, I think. This is a dilemma. I really want in there badly. And I worked so hard and spent so much time. It'd be a shame to quit now. I'm gonna go check out down here, leave my backpack up here for a second, see what we can work out. So there's a little crevice in here. It looks like the ground isn't too far down below, but once again, would I get stuck in there? I don't know. I might, very well might. So hopefully if you've come here, you weren't expecting like a pro rock climber dude. You got the Homer Simpson of rock climbers today. Oh boy. Okay, so it is now the next day. Wardrobe change has occurred and I'm back hitting this trail again, the Hall of Horrors. I could not find it. I just, you saw what I saw yesterday. And I was like, that's a bad idea for me to try to go down in that little chasm I found. Now, I don't know where that leads. That seemed to be something, and it seems doable. So if that's your thing, go explore it. Maybe that was what some people call the mini chasm of doom. I'm not sure. But as for the Hall of Horrors, when I went back home, I was like, let me look on the internet one more time. And then I found a good video that approximated where to go this time. And sure enough, I found it. I was so unsure I would find it or that I'd be able to get down in there that I didn't even bother to bring this camera. Brought a different camera, got some still shots and stuff, but I was that unsure, but I was like, it was bothering me. And I drove by here again. And I just said, I'm gonna just go look one more time. And I'm so glad I did. So let me explain the error of my ways. Yesterday, so you got this big clump of rocks here, right? We were exploring over here and I climbed up in there and that's where I saw that really deep, thin chasm. And clearly many others have been up there. In fact, I wanna say I was way up towards the top, like right there, I see a yucca plant that I think was the one I was rubbing up against. So up between there, problem is that's not where we need to be. We need to go further down that way. So in retrospect, I totally would still recommend, heading off to the right when you start off to the right of this rock instead of the left. Every other video I saw of people doing this came from the left. And there's a good reason why you might want to do that, but it is a long walk around that side. So if you're down for the long walk, cool. But if you really want to just get into this thing, I would recommend sticking to the right and just follow this path that I'm on here, the sandy little wash. And you can't mess that up really. And we're just gonna kinda, doesn't really matter how you do it. Just there's many trails intersecting the desert here. You know what? I feel like going this way, why not? Just to show you, it doesn't really matter, but we'll be up a little bit closer to the rocks. So I purposely overshot my destination, to be honest. So we came once again around the other corner of this guy, and I just came way out here. Maybe you want to do the same actually, and I'll explain why, but pretty much just come out past this big thing. Even if you take the trail that goes to the right, if you decide to come from this direction, then you're naturally going to hit here. But what you're looking for is a sign that looks like that. And that there is going to get you on the right path to finding this thing. I think most people can do what I'm about to do. But I'll let you judge for yourself. Just, don't push yourself too hard because you can hurt yourself. It's a little adventurous, but certainly within the realm of feasibility for some. Okay, so you can see there's lots of foot traffic that goes through here. And I'm gonna turn around one more time. And you can see the trail, the sign was down there and we just walked up this way. And I'm just pretty much walking straight from that sign. There are other trails that go around that way, Don't need to worry about that. Just come over this way. Follow the directions. Kind of squeeze through some of these places here carefully. And then you'll see this round rock here like this. Just walk up this bad boy, just like so. And look how easy the way actually is if you come this way. And next, it's almost like someone created a path for you here. You just gotta climb the rocks like this. There's the trail we took straight up here, up that smooth rock down here. Had to climb those, that wasn't too hard, but do have to really rely on your legs at the end to push up. But probably the most sketchy part is now. Have to traverse this because we want to get in there. That's where we're heading. You just want to be careful and don't look down. That's my best advice. And I just kind of like, you know, use these as a stepping stool, just like so. And you can even like come down this way like that. And then once you get about here, you're really almost there. I'm looking into the Hall of Horrors right now, the real Hall of Horrors. What you really need is good balance or patience. There's lots of other ways you can go about it, but for me, the easiest is literally just one at a time. Slowly, slowly come over here. And the last obstacle really is climbing down this boulder, which I assure you is not as bad as it looks. What I like to do is get on my butt like this. This rock is abrasive, so you're gonna scuff your hands up a little, but just deal with it. And I like to step here, put my hand here, just gently come down. It's that easy.
The real Hall of Horrors.
Oh my God. I made it into the real Hall of Horrors. There's a breeze blowing through these rocks like a natural air conditioner. Woo doggy. I feel good. I feel real good. For those of you that have hiked slot canyons like I have, this feels exactly like that. Just a few feet across from side to side. We're really just inside a giant crack between these rocks. But it is amazing. It's so cool and nice in here. I love this. This is a nice reprieve from that harsh sun out there. I wonder why this got the name Hall of Horrors, though. This is just the Hall of Awesome, is what I would call it. I'm wondering if there was a way to climb this, which I don't think I can do. there's more of a crack up there, and it may continue. I'm estimating that I was over there, like a lot further that way yesterday. Probably looking at the similar crack, but just a different section that you can't get to from here. This is really awesome. I know I've said that probably a million times. The Hall of Horrors. Just imagine the mass of one of these things. Like I'm on, you know, on either side of me. Like if this thing just decided to go crump and like fill up and close off, I would be squashed like an ant. So I want to know if you guys have other secrets like this here at Joshua Tree National Park. I know there's something called the Chasm of Doom, I believe, which seems a little bit more adventurous than this. And there's some really tight squeezes in there. And I don't know, maybe I want to lose a little bit of weight or go with a friend to do that one. But yeah, this one, I think, you know, that you could solo this one, no problem. Just, you know, don't break a leg or twist your ankle, but yeah, you got this. And if you've ever been here to the Hall of Horrors or you wanna come see it, feel free to ask me any questions in the comments. And if you have been here, I wanna hear what you thought about it. So also comment down below and tell me what your experience was like. So the next time you're at Joshua Tree National Park and you see that little stop on the map, Hall of Horrors, to the public, most people, Hall of Horrors are just those really big rocks and They don't know why they named it that, but for those in the know, like you, my friends, there is a real Hall of Horrors hidden just out of sight. Come find it.